pleased to be joined in person in the flesh here on the Rich Eisen Show. You love him on Around the Horn. He's been a Denver Post columnist since 1981. He's the author of Super Broncos, From Elway to Tebow to Manning. Woody Paige.
Hey, Rich.
How are you?
Congratulations on the new show.
Thank you.
Appreciate really it. Love the hardwood floor and the view.
Thank you. I will take that and run with it, sir. So you put Tebow in your book's title. Is that to move product? Anything with the T word in it moves product.
You're the only guy that's gotten that. that when you Google Tebow, the book will come up.
That's genius.
He had truthfully those three quarterbacks. There was a day mm-hmm. where they all three were involved with the Denver Broncos organization, and they were three of the most legendary quarterbacks. Now Tebow is legend for a different reason, but it was an interesting segment in the history of the Denver Broncos, who started out on this field.
Sure.
Let me tell you something you don't know. This was the city dump in the 60s.
This is where we are currently sitting right now.
Yeah, because we're just west of downtown, uh-huh. and this is the dumping ground. And the baseball owners who were southwest of here bought the land for $2,500 and put a little baseball stadium up here, and it turned into Mile High Stadium, which is now turned into what this is.
No kidding. Now, there was a poll recently, I don't know who's involved in these polls, saying that the Denver Broncos are the most popular team in all of the NFL, even more than the Dallas Cowboys. What stock do you put in that?
Well, I think if the Harris poll, which did that,
yes.
were to have a revote, the Cowboys right now, the Cowboys might pass the Broncos back.
Right.
But that's all about Manning. I think when you have the Manning and Elway connection, and even though the Tebow, that was an incredible season when he came in, I think that all of that adds to the mystique of the Denver Broncos, and a lot of people love Peyton Manning.
Isn't it incredible what Elway has done in his career? I mean, so few people can actually go from Hall of Fame quarterback for a team and then come and run the team and get that team into the Super Bowl. And if he wins it, obviously, you know, Ozzie Newsom has a bust in the bust room and has a Super Bowl ring as a general manager, and Elway could join him in that regard. But it's just remarkable, certainly from this area, Woody.
Yeah, given if you kind of study Elway's occupation after he got out of football was as a car dealer. Mm-hmm. And he built that up so much that he was bought out by a national firm. And he was kind of looking around for what he was going to do. And he really wanted to be in football. He and Mike Shanahan, who were so close, had a falling out. And Elway really was persona non grata out at Death Valley.
Uh-huh.
Really wouldn't even go out there. Normally, you would have an ex-quarterback come out and maybe work with a young quarterback. But he wasn't a part of the team. He had talked about helping bring a team back to Los Angeles. He was going to run for governor. He was asked by the Republicans in Colorado to run for governor. I think he would have won. You always hear the stories of
sure.
he could run for mayor, he could run for
yep.
governor. He would have won going away. And on his 50th birthday, he and I had a conversation at his restaurant here in town. And I said, what would you really like to do? And he said, I'd really like to get back with the Broncos. And that was a front page story. And it ended up that Pat Bowlen talked to him. Josh McDaniels was here, was not doing well. The team was at one of its lowest ebbs since the 60s. And the two of them talked, and that's how that evolved. And then John Elway had studied under his father, Jack, who was a longtime coach in college, a longtime personnel guy in the NFL, including here. He had studied with him about scouting. And that's the one thing that I think people really don't realize, that John put in a lot of time when he was out of football working with his father. And I'll give you an example real quick, that they were looking at films of a young college quarterback, and John said, he'll never play in the NFL. And his father said, you're totally wrong. You're not looking inside his heart. And he started talking to him about this kid that he'd gone and talked to
mm-hmm.
and turned John around. That kid was Drew Brees. And John said he learned from that moment that you had to look inside a guy's mind and his heart, not just at his size or his weight or some of his abilities as a football player.
A couple minutes I have left with you, Woody. What about the Super Bowl readiness for this team, the one that we're going to see on the field tonight?
This is a better team than it was last year. And I think they actually exhumed all the ghosts in Seattle. Even though they lost the game, they played with Seattle. They came back. They almost won the game. And I believe that that has done more for this season than any of the victories, even the one against San Francisco on Sunday night. I think this is a team that actually feels like this year, if it goes, last year everybody thought the Broncos were going to win. Mm-hmm. They couldn't play with Seattle. They can play with Seattle. They can play with San Francisco.
What about Dallas?
I guess that's still
to be determined. They may see each other.
People tend to forget that game last year with Dallas in Dallas was like 50-48.
It was with Danny Trevathan picking off Romo at the very end of the game. It was, you know, 50 burger against a 40 burger. As a Woody Paige, Super Broncos from Elway to Tebow to Manning. Do you think we'll ever see Tebow play again in the NFL?
No, but there are some leagues coming up that I think. He's getting more comfortable in his role as an analyst. He's now criticizing
Florida. He's popping off on the Gators. Yeah, I know. It is.
Nice. Thank you. My name has never been on the stadium scoreboards like yours, but to be on your show, that's
well, come on, incredible. Though. I mean, around the horn, they don't show that up on the scoreboards here? Like
most people in Denver don't even know that I do.
Oh, that is ridiculous. That is definitely.
I thought the game was at 2 o'clock, though. Where is everybody?
Well, you know what? We can move the time up. We have that sort of ability to try and at least find the right people for that. Woody, thanks so much for coming on. I really appreciate you coming on here on this show. And
I appreciate it.
I mean, we've got this is an old-time rivalry here. I mean, Greg Aiello tweeted out a picture of that from 1960 of the vertical socks that they were, the vertical stripes.
You know,
socks.
And they bought those from a defunct bowl. Mm-hmm. They bought the entire uniforms and they were miscolored and they had those circus socks. Mm-hmm. They've come a long
way. They have
way
evolved.
From the 60s.
Yes, there it is. From 1960, the AFL and the vertically striped socks.
And it was in this stadium where the dump was, and they played like they were in a dump.
Oh, you're the man, Woody. I really appreciate it. Thanks again for coming on right here.
Pleasure. Enjoy this beautiful day.
I am
love
certainly doing that.
Love the smell of grass in the morning.
I know.
I guess I shouldn't say that in Colorado now. Well.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.